flat desert and small ocean in the town of Chihuahua. Just like any other tiny town, it had a main street lined with stores, about 300 people, but there were no food stores in town.
They didn't need you. This guy supplied as much food as they could possibly want.
When the towns flew outside, they carried their plates, cups, glasses, forks, spoons, knives, and napkins with them.
That way they would be prepared for any kind of weather.
Thank you.
hot dogs already in the world, blew in from the northwest at about 5 miles an hour.
There were mustard clouds nearby, and pickerels fell from the sky like hail. And finally, slices of watermelon finished off the meal.
The sanitation department had the unusual job
of removing the food that fell on houses, sidewalks, and lawns.
They emptied some of the healthier foods like strawberries, kiwis, and papayas into the surrounding oceans full of fish, turtles, and whales.
And then the next day, it rained Brussels sprouts covered in peanut butter and mayonnaise. On Tuesday, there was a hurricane of red rolls all day long and into the night.
People were getting frightened. Violent storms blew up frequently. Awful things were happening.
Most of it was larger than they had ever seen. It was a terrible day.
Some walls were hard and some walls were soft. Some with seeds and some without.
The next day, there was a downpour of pasta sauce that nearly flooded the town.
Spaghetti noodles covered the entire school.
No one could get the noodles off, so they had no choice but to close the school.
Yeah. bread rafts held up surprisingly well, enough for the people to make new houses for themselves made of bread.
Children began school again, and their parents found new jobs in the wind.
People had to get used to buying food at a supermarket, though they found it odd that food was kept on shelves.
On the first day of winter, townspeople woke up and went outside to see fresh snow falling from the sky.
As they ran out to go sled down a big hill, they saw a pat of butter at the top, and they could almost smell the mashed potatoes.
Set up. Thank you to our teachers. Thank you to Mrs. Coughlin for all your hard work, all the extra plan time you gave to our students to make this possible. Thank you again. All right, parents. I had a 10-minute speech set up, but I know some of you are going to go to the Blues game tonight, so let's hold on here. This is your time right now. Third grade, stay face forward, stand still. This is picture time. All right, smile, smile, smile. Smile, keep smiling, keep smiling. Hands down. A few more smiles, hands down. All right, now more pictures. Silly face, silly face, silly face. Five more, you can do better than that. Come on, third grade, I see you be sillier at school. And there we go. All right, let's give our third grade a hand. So we want to also, we have our fifth grade performing just a little bit, so we want to help them get ready for that. So we're going to have our students, who we got, whose class is over here? Angle Reckon. Parents, we want you to take your kids home tonight, so we're going to have our staff at the wings and have them come on Engelbrecht's class. You can come on down through the stairs and meet your family out in the auditorium. And whose class is over here? McCarty's class. Students, do not go out of the auditorium. Meet your family. We'll wait a second, too. Okay, and this Cortez's class, we both lead them out this way, too. Families, thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening. If you're staying for fifth grade, we'll see you in a few minutes for that show. Thank you.
You ready?
I just need my people to get the lapel mic. I need them.
Oh, does she have them? Oh, your kids with that need them.
Yeah.
That's the three of them right there.
Why'd they come up here then?
Yeah, okay. Oh, those are nice Chuck Smith. Fake. Those are pants. Converse.
when you pack it for her.
I can't tell you how many times I've grabbed my phone because I've had this one and these pants and they fall out. And girl pants, their pockets are like this deep.
Yeah, I know.
You know why they do that? Do you know why they do that with girl pants? Because then if you can't fit your phone in your pocket, you have wipers. Look at you. Look how deep all your pockets are. You can fit a whole wallet in there. Well, those are dream shorts.
Can't fit a wallet.
I can't. These aren't.
Now, they do say that, like, they have bigger pockets, they stick out. It's not just
flattering. Really, you can't put just a bunch of stuff in.
I'd rather have big
pockets.
Like, anytime you have a pop or a dress, it's the nighttime you get a dress, you're like, oh my gosh, this dress has pockets in it.
It's like the tiniest little pockets ever.
And I
have
to learn that I'm like, oh.
You good?
Right. You're there and you can put it down here separately, but. And then, do you want them to stand on their end?
Yes.
Okay. And they're all on.
They're all on. I got it muted here until they get down there.
But they're all on, so you shouldn't have to mess with them at all.
Thank you. guys, did you notice how everything looks so strange?
Guys, I think we went too far back.
Thank you.
not right.
What strange clothes you have? You must be from quite a strange kingdom.
Yeah, something like that.
Do not fret. You are welcome to join our kingdom here. You will find the land to be quite a paradise.
Do you have video games here?
I don't even know what that means.
No TV, no video games.
Quick, let's get out of here.
Thank you. That hair was a choice.
Wait, no! Don't press the button!
Guys, I can't find it. There's no Netflix.
No!
I can't. There's nothing but commercial after commercial, and I can't skip them.
Wait, here's something on this channel, something called Fresh Prince of Bel Air.
Thank you.
mean? When are we?
I have no idea. We seem to be in more than one time. Look, there are the kings and queens from before.
Hey, doesn't that guy look kind of like Abraham Lincoln?
What's Abraham Lincoln doing in the 1700s?
Guys, there's a gas station over there. I think we somehow mixed up the timeline. It's a mashup.
Thank you.
Bye. Adventure!
Thank you. Hey, let's see. Let's give a hand to our fifth graders again.
From the stage, but before they do that, I want to give you an opportunity to take a picture of them standing up here really, really fast. So, face this way, put your hands down. We'll do a silly one in a sec, where you can throw all the rock ones you want. So face them, smile, and picture, picture, picture. Okay, now do something real silly. I know you know how to do it. Do it. Ready, go. June, I love it. And good. Okay, thank you. Before we dismiss, I want to thank our parents who helped build our beautiful sets that we have over here. Bo's mom built this one over here, and this one is amazing. Thank you so much. We have help from Rylan's mom. Tonight is the first time we had a 30 Comfort 6 that we've had a concert for Crestwood since 2019. So it's been a really long time, and it's been so amazing and fun working with your children. I love them so much. Their level of like professionalism when we've been practicing has been amazing. They don't do this in my classroom, but in rehearsal, I only have to tell them something one time, and they remember it. They're just so focused. They're amazing. I love them so much.
Hey, fifth grade. How about Mrs. Kaufman right here? What do you say? Well, we're gonna dismiss you, but the amount of time it takes on a 4-day rotation, all the extra plan time that you've given, and the opportunity, the unique opportunity to perform, this is unrepeatable. This is an amazing, remember this moment. This is such a cool bonding moment. I remember when I was in college and high school performing the music. This is special, so thank you, audience. Mac, you rocked the front row. I saw you dancing. You guys rocked it. Thank you again. We're gonna dismiss from here fast, so we're gonna ask teachers